Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Hey guys, you know, getting a dog is one of life's greatest blessings. And quite honestly, you want it to last forever. Unfortunately, most dog breeds don't live as long as us humans do. But for a tragic group of breeds, they have very, very short lifespans. Hey guys, this is Zeke. This is Dogumentary TV, the YouTube channel for dog lovers. If you guys have not already, please subscribe to the channel. Also, if you want to go a step further, please join the channel, become a channel member. Your support goes a long way in helping me produce the kind of content that you see here. Also, in the description of this video, there are links to affiliates. If you guys are looking for any products or merchandise, check out my affiliates. That's another great way to support the channel. All right, guys, let's jump into this video. The information I'll be giving you in this video is referenced from an article I found on stacker.com. The article gives data on the life expectancy of the top 47 dog breeds. For the sake of this video, I will be focusing on the 10 breeds with the shortest lifespans, and we'll talk about them and things that can be done to mitigate the short life expectancy and get a few extra years out of the breed. All right, guys, at number 10 is a Rhodesian Ridgeback, which really surprises me. Rhodesian Ridgebacks are typically a hardy breed, typically carry a good weight, very athletic, and I wouldn't expect to see them to be on this list with a life expectancy of 9.1 years, which is not a horrible number. Personally, I feel like you can get to double digits with a dog, meaning 10 years, you're doing pretty well. And that's for the most part, any dog breed. All right, guys, the number 9 dog breed on the list is a Saint Bernard with a life expectancy of 9 years. Obviously, this is a huge dog, so maintaining its weight, proper exercise, and humane living conditions. I'm a big believer that extreme heat or extreme cold will reduce a dog's life expectancy. Tied with the Saint Bernard at 9 years, life expectancy is the Shar Pei. 9 years is not an atrocious number for a breed's life expectancy, but you would think a breed like the Shar Pei, an average-sized breed that doesn't carry a lot of weight, you would expect to get a little more than 9 or 10 years out of this dog. My assumption would be that the breed's popularity in the 80s, where there was a lot of reckless breeding going on, has in some way affected the breed's current genetic stock, and that may be the reason why this breed doesn't have a longer life expectancy. Number 7 breed on the list is the Bull Mastiff, with an average lifespan of about 8.6 years, which again is not great. This is, though, a giant breed, and most giant breeds typically don't live as long as your smaller dog breeds. So my guess would be that the sheer size of the Bull Mastiff would be the reasoning behind its short life expectancy. But I do believe there are some things that you can do to get a few years out of your dog. At least there are some things that I would try if I had a Bull Mastiff. And they would be, first and foremost, to feed it a raw, clean diet and maintain a very healthy weight. In addition, I would keep the dog out of extreme heat. Number 6 on the list is the Bloodhound. The Bloodhound has an average lifespan of 8.5 years. Now, I don't know exactly why the Bloodhound has such a short life expectancy. I'm not that familiar with the breed. The breed is not tremendously large. It is a pretty big dog, but it's not a really what you would consider to be a giant breed. So I'm not exactly certain how you would go about mitigating a Bloodhound's life expectancy. But I would suggest that best practice is always to feed a clean diet, proper exercise, and the best living conditions possible. The number 5 breed on this list is the Great Dane. Like the Bull Mastiff, the Great Dane is a giant breed. And if you know anything about dogs, you will come to expect that larger dog breeds have shorter lifespans. The average lifespan for a Great Dane is 8.4 years, which is not terribly bad for such a large dog breed. To hopefully extend your dog's life, I recommend a clean diet, proper exercise, and again, human-like living conditions, meaning basically keep the dog in the house with you, keep the dog out of extreme weather conditions. All right, guys, the number four breed on the list is the Mastiff, the English Mastiff. It has a lifespan of about 7.5 years. Another giant breed. You would expect that on a list of short-lived dog breeds, you would find a lot of giant breeds. And the English Mastiff is probably the most giant of dog breeds. So it's not magic. There's no magic potion. Best practices for trying to get the most time out of an English Mastiff is proper exercise, proper diet, raw diet preferably, and great living conditions. In addition, with the English Mastiff, because it carries so much weight, I would highly recommend a joint supplement, something to make sure you keep the joints healthy and happy, because this dog will be carrying around a lot of weight. Even your most lean of Mastiffs will carry around a lot of weight. Third breed on the list is the Bernese Mountain Dog, average lifespan of about 7 years. This is a beautiful dog. I actually love the temperament. I love the gentle nature of this breed. I love the actual aesthetics. This is a beautiful dog to look at. But a lifespan of 7 years is tragic. If you know anything about a good friend or good friendships, you want them to last a lot longer than 7 years. I don't know exactly what the issue was with the breed, but having a recent conversation with a breeder, there are a lot of cancers and other genetic issues that go into these dogs passing away too early. You may not be able to lengthen the life of the dog, but you'll definitely give the dog a better quality of life with the proper diet, proper exercise, joint supplements, and good living conditions. All right, guys, the number two breed on the list, the English Bulldog. This breed has an average lifespan of about 6.7 years. Anyone that knows anything about the English Bulldog knows that this dog, for the most part, has been bred into a horrible corner. Breed aesthetics are not conducive for a long-lived dog. The bulky body is just not conducive to a dog that's going to live a long time. You want to mitigate some of the issues that you'll have with this dog breed. I don't know that you can extend the life of this breed much past the average, but obviously you can improve the quality of the dog's life. These dogs aren't going to exercise a lot, but as much exercise as a dog will participate in, they can be stubborn, so you gotta be gentle and trying to encourage them to exercise. Definitely keep these dogs out of extreme heat and extreme cold conditions. All right, guys, the dog breed with the worst and the shortest life expectancy, the Irish Wolfhound. Another very giant dog breed. The average lifespan for an Irish Wolfhound is about 6.2 years. Aside from its size, I really wouldn't have any other indications that this breed should have a short lifespan. And definitely not this short. It's a giant breed, but to only live about 6.2 years is really sad, I guess, is really what it is. Again, I don't know that you can extend a dog's life much past the average, but I think best practices will dictate that you feed the dog a healthy diet, plenty of exercise. These dogs can and will run. They are runners, so good exercise. They're big dogs, they're heavy dogs, so a joint supplement would be great and give the dog the best living conditions possible. All right, guys, there you have it. The 10 dog breeds with the shortest lifespans. Obviously, as dog lovers, we want to have our dogs for as long as possible. I have the dog, a pit bull mix. He's going to be 14 in a month. So I'm very happy with what I've gotten out of him. All right, guys, if you guys have an expectation on how long you want to live with your next dog breed, please leave a comment and I'll check it out and I'll get back to you guys very shortly. All right, peace.